I scare you a little bit. I scare you. Do I scare you a little bit?
No, you don't actually scare me because I get you, babe.
Right, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're like my little brother and my big brother. I get you.
This is Veronica Webb. Veronica, who is more than a friend, more than someone I worked with, but she's actually a muse.
One day we're going to sing a song together.
Will we?
Yes.
I didn't know you sang.
I don't. I'm interested in the doing of it. I'm interested in the
next segment, darling. Yes, you can set up a piano and a drum kit and a bass fiddle and you and me. What's one thing about me that you could tell them that they don't know?
Isaac loves flowers because plants make material.
You're right. That's true.
Mm-hmm.
That's insane. I thought you were going to say that I have really smooth, hairless legs.
Oh, I forgot about that. But that's also
the truth. No kidding, like no hair on my, it's the strangest thing. A few like bruises, but no hair.
Yeah, no, yours look like mine after like 10 rounds of
right,
laser.
Right, exactly. I'm serious. It's so sad. I'm also the
it's
whitest, most like, you know, sort of, what's that stuff called? That cottage cheese. What is that stuff called?
Can't you just say what? Alabaster?
Alabaster, nice.
Must you say cottage cheese?
Well, you
must
know.
You, must you put yourself down? Must you?
Now, like, could I tell you one thing about Veronica that no one would know about her? I can't. I can't think of one thing that I could say in public about Veronica that people don't know. I could say a few things that people don't know, but that would make some people very nervous, and I won't say it.
You shan't.
I shan't.
Yeah,
shan't.
You shall it. You
I shan't
and you shall it.
I shan't.
We met at Calvin Klein in a fitting.
That's right.
And
that's
you
right.
You made the black lace dress with the elastic spaghetti straps.
That's
you had
right.
To fight for that dress size.
But also, Veronica said the funniest thing in the world because Edward Wilkerson was working with us too.
Yes, he was.
And Calvin, it was like some kind of mad like salon at Calvin. There were like hundreds of people there, racks of clothing, stacks of shoes, insanity, and like.
And every talented person you ever met worked
was
there.
In that room. And by the way, like there were people who were cleaning up and getting dinner and ordering stuff. Mm-hmm. And Edward said to somebody, he said, "Could you get me a Sweet and Low, please?" or something, right? And you said to him, "Excuse me, does she look like Mr. French to you?" Right? And I thought, Mr. French, like even then it was an old reference. You know, even then it was kind of a hilarious reference. And that's when I noticed Veronica, when she said Mr. French.
Well, and also our hair was exactly the same.
At the time, exactly, right.
We both had like curly high top fades.
Yes, we did.
We looked like Kid and Play.
And you know, Christian, remember Christian?
Yes.
He told me that I should never wash my hair again and that I should put olive oil in it every day. And I did for years.
How'd that work out for
it
you?
It was fantastic. I had like sort of dreads, uh-huh. as close to dreads mm-hmm. as you can get mm-hmm. if you're me. And also a swarm of flies around my head most times.
That's so fashion.
That's how we met, right?
Yes.
And then we became like actual friends.
Yes.
Which is like, you know, not that common. You know, you'd
no.
see pictures of people on red carpets and they're captioned as friends. But they're not, okay? They know absolutely nothing about each other's lives.
Or they're just red carpet friends.
They're red carpet friends, exactly. I used to have this joke about Veronica, like, I'll just leave her in the room with the accessories and she'll do the fitting, you know? Seriously, because it was better. She always had better ideas. And also, she had like a mercenary streak in her. I'd say, oh, bracelets? And she'd say, can you sell them? And I'd say, yes. And she'd say, yes, then bracelets. I mean, like, you know, that's who she is too, to some extent, right?
Well, you know, it has to be a business, right? Otherwise,
yes.
You might as well go
Which
back.
Makes me think
I
that...
I mean, even when you had puppet shows, it was a business. You know
I guess
I mean?
So, except I never made any money with the puppet shows.
You didn't?
No, hell no. I just opened the door, and if people came to see, that's it.
Oh,
oh no, you're right.
You,
I
you did.
I did birthday parties,
yeah,
yes.
And the bar and bat mitzvahs.
That's
yes,
right, I did. Oh my God.
I know you.
This is like that English game show. Where you have like Cher and Cher's fan, and uh-huh. they like, they say, oh, in 1964, you and you know, raindrops keep falling on my head with, you know, Sergio Mendez collaboration. And Cher is like, wait, did I collaborate with Sergio Mendez? And the fan knows it. Mm-hmm. You never saw that show?
You love a game show.
I love a game show. I also love London. I love game shows in London because you don't win anything. You win like an encyclopedia or something.
<That's so funny. laughs>
It's really true. Like, did you notice there's RuPaul Drag Race UK and there's no money? You win like a badge if you win. Or you win like the opportunity to like fly to Hollywood and make a video. That's what you win if you win RuPaul Drag Race. We traveled together.
We went to Boston and Chicago.
We went to Boston. Do you remember that Boston trip, darling? What was supposed to be, it's a 15 minute flight or something like that. Mm-hmm. With you and like Linda and Naomi Campbell and like, I think Christy was there. I think literally everybody, we were going for the now like sort of defunct Barney's, which is sad. We were going for the opening of the Barney's in Boston.
Oh,
and somehow there was a crazy like storm or something. And now you can't be kept on the tarmac for longer than 3 hours legally. Mm-hmm. We were on the tarmac for 5 hours.
We were.
With Naomi Campbell, okay? With these people, all right? That happened.
I guess I blocked it out.
You were like, yeah, I remember Barney's in Boston. We got there and like the crowd had come and gone, right? The crowd that was gathering for us in Boston had come, they had assembled and they left. And then they got more people there. I'm not sure how they did it. Like we were like literally 5 hours late and they got people there.
He hates to travel. He never goes anywhere.
I go everywhere. Veronica, I'm
now
so,
you do.
Oh, now I do. I used to always go places and then I stopped because I hated it. But where else? We never went to Paris together.
No.
You didn't come with me.
We went to
Boston
and Chicago.
That's it?
And
Los Angeles? We were never in Los Angeles together.
Yes, we did go to Los Angeles.
We did, exactly. Oh, yes, we did, for instance.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
You just have to remember. I think we've also been abroad together, darling, at some point. I do, yeah. I do. In Paris, all those shows and things, and Japan, or no? Shanghai, Korea? No?
Those other models, darling.
Tell me where to go. Where would I go now? Because you know what? Like I have been places, okay? And I was trying to like tell this to Arnold in a nice way. Mm-hmm. But like, you know, the last time I was at the Borghese Palace in Rome, there was a party being thrown for me. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You get it, right?
Yeah,
we
yeah.
talk about this a lot, how it was this kind of like when I went to Versailles the first time, it was with Andre Leon Talley in the backseat of a Mercedes limousine and he was playing Delight. And it was just us in Versailles and he was showing me as if it was his living room, which it pretty much is, right? It's Andre's living room. You see what I mean? And like, you get where I'm going with this. And now you go to Rome and you go to these places and it's impossible. You can't get next to the Mona Lisa. Mm-hmm. You can't get next to the David. You can't get next to the Trevi Fountain. It's impossible. So now you tell me where to go. Could you please?
I think you should go where I want to go.
Sweden?
Botswana. We should see the animals. Because we've seen a lot of buildings and a lot of paintings.
We have. We do love the paintings and the restaurants and the people, don't we?
But we've done it.
Maybe you're right. Maybe we've done most of it.
It's time to go see the animals. It's time to take a doctor.
You might be right. You might be right. Like go on safari or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Veronica and Isaac in the jungle.
Oh my God. Wait a second. Listen, because I would like to know, like, do you have any plans to do this?
I'm looking into it.
All right. You think that Chris would like to go?
Yes, he would like it.
Okay, so this
Arnold
is a...
Arnold would like it.
Arnold would love it. Are you kidding me? He would love it. And you don't think we'd be a little scared and bored and like allergic and sickly if we went?
But don't you feel that way when you go to the Borghese Palace?
Yes.
It's not like you're going to be
so
any
right.
different when you go there than you are anywhere else.
But I will say that in Rome, there is the promise of an amazing bowl of pasta and like a beautifully roasted fish.
They have all that. Like the whole safari game is together.
They have pasta in Botswana?
Well, if they don't have pasta, I'm sure they have something else. Isaac,
I'm just kidding. I'm just
fine.
Teasing. I'm just
you'll
teasing. That's a total show. Isaac and Veronica on safari, right? It's a limited series.
Find the giraffe.
It's a limited series on Amazon.